We are making a huge amount of progress in our understanding. We know a lot, but I feel like there is no single function of the brain that I would say we understand from the level of, you know, the signals entering the brain to the behavior.
Look, the human brain's exceptionally complicated. 86 billion neurons, each of them having 10,000 synapses or so. And all these neurons interact, they're all active all the time. It's not like that you only use a seventh of them, you use all of them. And so figuring out how they all interact with one another is just exceptionally complicated.
The way we think about it, it's really the most complex object being studied in science today. What we're really after in the OpenScope program is to look at the signals that course through this awesome network and create behavior, our thoughts, our actions, consciousness. That's really what the OpenScope program is for, to explore dynamics of electrical signals in this very, very complex network.
The OpenScope program is a way to democratize science. Let's think about the Hubble telescope or other telescopes out there. And the OpenScope program was modeled on this notion that telescopes are instruments that many scientists need to answer different kinds of questions. And what if that could be done for neuroscience?
The OpenScope program is the aspiration to replicate what astronomy has done. This facility is not to run our experiment or my experiment, but we're making it available to any scientist anywhere on the planet. They can apply to it. We will run the experiment and we'll make it the data available to them and ultimately to the entire community.
OpenScope is a platform that was built at the Allen Institute for instruments such as these that are behind me. And we make them available to the community at large. We need that because those sophisticated tools are only available to a few labs in the community. And we think it's slowing down progress. We want to make them available to the entire world so that together we can build complex knowledge integration models that tackle the modern question of system neuroscience.
We're capable of doing this because the Institute has pioneered some of the best technology to intervene in the mouse brain, to classify the individual neurons using cell types, to have these very high density technology called neural pixel, where you take, you know, electrode half the width of a human hair and you stud them with hundreds or now soon thousands of electrodes. You can put them into the brain, you can process all the data, and then also putting it up in the cloud so that people can directly access it. This is what we've done over the last 20 years. So that's why we're the best place on the planet to lead this effort.
I think at its base level, it's an incredible learning opportunity. If we want to raise the next generation of neuroscientists, having access to open source data is where they can sharpen their teeth, if you will, with data computation. So I think the Allen Institute's OpenScope data pack notebook structure is amazing for this and already being used in summer schools and courses. Like, I even use it in teaching at university level.
One of the biggest challenges for computational neuroscientists is the wide range of skill sets that we need in order to solve the big outstanding puzzles. That range of skills is so large that effectively no scientist can do it all. And so having the ability to deploy these really high quality facilities with technical experts at the Allen Institute to run those experiments and test our ideas has really been a game changer.
This never happens in basic research in academia. We're just a bunch of cowboys, right? You know, just doing everything sort of on the fly, and every experiment is a little different from every other, and it's kind of necessary in the process of discovery for researchers to have that flexibility, but it's rare then to have a large data set that was collected under pristine, reproducible, perfectly documented, absolutely objective conditions. And so these are really treasured data sets because they're not being collected anywhere else.
It's like basically having the same language for neuroscience. If you have the same data, you can then have different conclusions that would be based on the same data, and you would understand each other quicker and you would move forward quicker. So I think OpenScope in that sense is like having the same language, it's having the same data, it's having the same baseline, so we can progress further faster.
This concept, the observatory concept in neuroscience, is still very new, and I would say 90% of neuroscientists are not aware of it. And the 10% that are aware of it are extremely enthusiastic. And especially those who've touched the OpenScope project are most enthusiastic of all.
It was just such a great experience because I was introduced to the way that Allen Institute does science, and it's just an incredible model and one that I hope more institutions will adopt.
By giving an open competition where anyone can propose their ideas, here's this hypothesis I'd like to test, here are the experiments I'd like you to run, the OpenScope program really does democratize the most advanced neuroscience experiments out there.
I think it's a way to change the culture of science. And perhaps that's more important than either it being an instrument, a way for people to ask questions, but how we do science in the future.